Hello everyone, welcome to Desilicious Kitchen. Today we are going to see how to make Kathrikai Gutsu. Kathrikai is a Tamil word for bangan or eggplant. And gutsu is a side dish for idli, dosa, rice and more importantly pongal or South Indian khichdi. In short, Kathrikai Gutsu is a South Indian version of the North Indian bangan ka bharta. So now without much ado, let us see how to make this Kathrikai Gutsu. So to make this gutsu, we have taken three big eggplants. Together, they weigh 900 grams in total. We have washed them and dried them thoroughly. This will serve four people. So let me begin by showing you how I roasted one eggplant. So here I am applying some oil to the eggplant. Applying oil will help the skin to get roasted well and it will give a nice burnt flavor. Now I am making slits with a knife like this. This way the eggplants will get cooked or roasted right inside also. Now I am going to insert some garlic or lasoon inside the deep slit on the side. This will give an amazing flavor when the garlic also roasts along with the eggplants. But if you do not want to add the garlic, you can skip it. Now let us roast the eggplant on fire. Roast on all sides. You can also use a skewer for roasting, but I prefer to roast it like this. You will need to roast it for at least 10 to 12 minutes. Now the skin of the eggplant is wrinkled. It is roasted. We have switched it off. Now we have put a tomato on a skewer and we are going to roast this too. We will roast it until the skin comes off slightly. Later on, we will cool it down and remove the skin and chop it. Let us cool it down. And in the meanwhile, we are roasting four red chilies on fire like this. Now we are going to crush the red chilies. But before that, I am just cutting them with the scissors and then crushing them like this. We don't want them powdered fine. We want it coarse like this. That will give an amazing taste to our bharta. I'm sorry, gutsu. Now it has cooled down and we are going to peel the skin of the eggplant. It is peeled. Now let us chop it into small pieces. And we are going to chop the tomato also after peeling it. We want it finely chopped because this is going to be of mashy consistency. Now, to a pan, let us add tamarind juice, which we have extracted from one lemon-sized tamarind. This is about 3 cups tamarind juice. And to the tamarind juice, now we are adding the mashed roasted bangan or eggplant. And the roasted tomatoes that we had chopped. The roasted red chilies that we had crushed in the mortar and pestle. The gas is not on now. It is off. We are just mixing all this. Mix it well, add some salt and 1 tablespoon jaggery. Along with the tamarind, jaggery goes well to balance the taste. Now let us heat a pan and we are adding 4 tablespoons sesame seed oil. Sesame seed oil is used for the gutsu. 1 teaspoon mustard seeds when the oil is hot. When the mustard seeds crackle, we are adding jeera or cumin seeds. And now, garlic or lasoon, 5 big flakes. You can skip if you don't want. And this is ginger, 1 inch piece. Green chilies, 3 finely chopped. Give it a mix. And now we are adding 2 medium-sized onions which we have finely chopped. As I said, you can skip the garlic and onion if you don't want. But of course, they add to the taste. You don't have to brown the onions. When they just slightly change color, add turmeric powder or haldi powder. 1 teaspoon we have added. And 1/2 teaspoon Kashmiri red chili powder or lal mirch. Give it a quick mix. Add some salt. And now we are adding kadi patte or curry leaves, 1 tablespoon. And now we are adding the mixture of the tamarind juice, imli ka pani, roasted eggplant or baingan, tomato and red chilies. Mix it well and now we are going to cover and cook it on a low flame for about 8 to 10 minutes. Of course, we will be stirring intermittently. Now after 8 minutes, let us check on the guts. Wow! See, this is the perfect consistency. It is mashy now and the color is amazing and the aroma is of course superb. So now we are switching off the flame. And we are going to garnish it with some coriander leaves or hara dhania. You can serve this amazing gutsu with some hot rice or rotis. And of course, it goes best with pongal or South Indian khichdi. Please check it out on our channel. Hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did, give us a like by pressing the like button. Subscribe to our channel if you haven't. Comment and let us know how you did. Share this video with your friends and family. Thank you. See you soon with another video.